all. It is a literal ice storm here. Very strange. I've never seen anything like it in Texas at all. Everything is covered in ice. It's quite beautiful. But my face is so frozen I can barely talk. It is February in Texas, and we are in the midst of an ice storm. I'm sure by the time you watch this, it will feel like that was a long time ago, but we're in it right now. Tonight, the low is, I think, 19. Tomorrow night, the low is supposed to be 3. Crazy. So we're going to turn our water off so that the pipes don't burst. So we have to collect a bunch of water. So that is the task for this morning. We are storing a bunch of these cooking pots for a friend. So I think that we're gonna store a bunch of water in those. So now I just have to get them back to the house. This is pretty manual process right now. I'm just filling up a pot here and dumping into the big silver pots. Eugene is looking for a hose so that maybe I don't have to stand here all day and do this, but we'll see if he finds one. And the chicken's water keeps freezing. So I have this heating pad. It's for plants. It never turns off. So I have to figure out how to get some electricity over to the coop so that we can use this so I don't have to keep going with boiling water and unfreezing their drinking water. So I have to get the extension cord in here, but I still want to be able to keep their door closed. So I think if I take out a few screws here, I can just slide it behind this fence and it will be in there and it will still be safe from predators. Okay, that gives me enough room, I think, to get this in. Yes! Success! Well, I just came to the coop maybe 30 minutes ago. This is already frozen again, so I'll have to go boil some water so that I can even get into the coop. since we might lose water for a few days, I just took a nice, long, hot shower. Scrubbed myself really well, so I stay clean for a while. Cold and snowy. We have no running water, but we prepared for that yesterday. My face is frozen. We do have electricity because we're on solar, so that's good. We do not have any cell phone service. We have not since, I don't know, late last night, I guess.
We're heading down to our neighbor's house right now because we don't have any cell phone. This is the winter fashion. We're walking, if I didn't make that clear. We're walking down.
I wanted to give you a little update on the chicken coop. We have them blocked off in the inner coop right now. And we tarped it off. That heating pad that you saw me kind of trying to get it into the coop, I got it in. It didn't do anything to keep the water from freezing. So I've just been coming out every couple of hours with a new plastic bowl. Plastic freezes less quickly than their metal bowl. So I've been coming out with a plastic bowl of water and switching it out every couple of hours. The garden covered in first a layer of ice and then snow. I have no idea if anything is still alive under here. We'll find out after the thaw, I suppose. We are getting pretty low on firewood, and as you can see, it's still cold. So we have this big bonfire that we haven't burned, so we went and got a log from it, and Eugene's gonna cut it up, and we're gonna test it and see if even though it's wet, will it burn, you know, with other dry logs. And then I think we're gonna go disassemble that bonfire and cut it up for firewood because I don't know what else to do. Disassembling the bonfire for firewood. Thank you. This is our rental cabin, and you can see that the snow is starting to melt, and we are discovering where things have leaked and pipes have broken, and we had a broken pipe down here. So this is where a pipe busted. So we're about to get in and replace it with this much better piece. Might be a little messy. See, we invested in cheap PVC parts that didn't withstand the test of time or cold temperatures. So moral of the story is buy the right equipment the first time so that you don't have to replace it. The snow is finally starting to thaw. I uncovered my bed of greens, and the collard greens and the kale both look fine. I'm very excited to eat some tonight because we haven't had anything fresh in quite a while. But tonight is still a low of 16, so I need to cover this bed up. I don't know if you can tell, but most of the snow has melted. We still don't have running water. I'm wearing these earrings to try and distract you from the fact that I haven't washed my hair in a week. I don't know if it's helping, but here is what I'm going to try to summarize our experience during this Texas crazy snowmageddon thing. Our solar power was wonderful. We didn't lose power once. Everything was great there. The wood stove kept us warm even when sometimes the daytime temperatures were in the teens. We did almost run out of firewood, but we disassembled our bonfire and we had plenty of firewood. So the water situation, we drained a lot of our tanks and pipes really well. Those held up fine. For some reason, I don't know, I can't crawl into Eugene's head and tell you, and he can't really tell you either. He did not 100% drain the pipes at our house. And I'm only saying this, it's embarrassing and just ridiculous, but I'm saying it because maybe some of you will remember me saying this, and in the future when you have your off-grid place, or now when you do, you'll remember to fully drain your pipes. Because anywhere that there was water in the pipes, even a tiny bit, I guess it got so cold that the water expanded so much and it burst through some of the connectors, the PVC connectors. And now things are thawing out and we're trying to restore water here at our house. But we're seeing that as the water flows through, we're seeing the different places where the pipes are messed up and busted. So Eugene left to go get some pieces, and we're really hoping that we can get some water soon because my head is itchy and I want to take a shower. But overall, we're fine. We're fine. My garden, I lost my cauliflower, some of my broccoli, my chard is frozen, but I still see some green growth in the middle of it, so that's good. So not a huge loss there either, so we feel really blessed and grateful. The chickens are dust bathing. They were cooped up, you know, during the ice storm for almost a week, so they're really happy to be out and get some dust in their feathers. We're all happy that the snow is gone and the sun is shining. Now we just have to fix all the pipes that busted. What do you think, Primo? Are you happy to be outside? So I got Eugene to tell us a little bit about this new system because all the original pipes burst in here. So what are these pipes? How are these different than our other ones?
Yeah, so the original pipes were PVC, which is commonly used here in Texas and more in older houses, and it does not sustain weather really well. And so we went with a whole new system, which means you have to get all new pieces and all new tools, but it's called PEX. It's a flexible pipe, very easy to install. There's no gluing. It's just these rings with a special tool that get cramped around these brass fittings. Everything is solid and nothing should burst. The pipes are also expandable when they freeze, so should be a lot safer, longer lasting, stronger system.
Well, we tested the water and there are no leaks. So Eugene did a great job, and we now have water restored at the cabin. wanted to update y'all with our new water system here. So this was all PVC previously, and everywhere that there was, I guess you call it an opener, like a valve, out of PVC, you know, it busted. So we got water restored at our house, you know, fairly recently. I think the storm was, I don't know, it feels so far away, maybe last week or something. But anyways, we got all of these nice, like, metal fittings now, and these are flexible as well, and if we ever have that kind of freak cold again, we can unscrew all these and just drain them really, really well. So, you know, it was a heartache, and it was a challenge and a struggle, but in the end, it's really good to switch over to a system that actually, you know, will work better for us in the future.